everybody. It's Connie Stewart with SimplySimpleStamping.com. I'm so excited to be back stamping with you. And today I've got a fun, easy to make shaker Christmas card. I love shaker cards, and the people who receive them love them too. I have got a super easy version of the shaker card, not complicated at all. I did it with a clear envelope, and I think you can see we've got a little snowy scene going on inside my shaker card. I think you're going to enjoy this one. So we're going to head over to the stamping table and get to creating. Let me give you a quick close-up of the card. I think you can see we've got some snow in here. We've got a few little snowflakes, and this card couldn't be any easier. But I want to share with you the supplies that you're going to need so that you can get started. My card base is a Whisper White thick, and that is cut 5.5 by 8.5, scored at 4.25 inch. And then I've got three pieces of cardstock. I have Night of Navy, I have Misty Moonlight, and Whisper White. My Night of Navy is 3.25 by 4.75. My Misty Moonlight, that is cut 2.75 by 4.25. And the Whisper White is 2.5 inches by 4. We're also going to need one of Stampin' Up's clear envelopes. This is kind of the magic to making the shaker card. We're also going to add a little bit of ribbon. And I thought the white with the silver metallic trim just gives it that real nice icy feel. And guys, we're simply just going to create a knot. And that's just going to polish off our card. Just give it a little extra something, something. The star of today's show is most definitely the Sunshine Wishes stamp set and the matching dies. I love this one. You can actually get this one as a bundle and save 10%. But first, we've got a 17-piece stamp set with lots of snowflakes and some great sentiments. And then look at this die set. Lots of snowflakes. And then also a great snowflake frame if you want to really put the focal image on your sentiment. But we're actually going to just be using one of the little dies for our shaker. Everything else is going to come from the stamp set itself. Now, the secret to my shaker card is how I created the snow. Are you ready for this? Guys, I used kosher salt. Yep, that is the magic in my shaker card, is just kosher salt. You'll see it's a little bit chunkier over table salt. I actually use kosher salt all the time in my cooking, but I do love the looks of that. Then if you would like, you can also come in and add some glitter to that salt. You can use any glitter you might have. It might be silver chunky glitter. It might be just an ultra fine iridescent glitter, but I think that glitter is going to give it just a really, again, that nice snowy feel that we're going for. Okay, let's get to creating. The first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to do a little embossing to the front of our card. And what could be more fitting than the winter snow embossing folder? We've got some really great, I hope you can see those snowflakes on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that embossing folder. We're going to insert our card. I'm going to line up the edge with the score line. I'm going to run that through my Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine. And look at that. Ooh, such great texture on the card. All right, the card base is done. Now we're going to do some stamping. I've got three ink pads for my stamping today. Night of Navy, that Misty Moonlight, and then Balmy Blue. So we're going to bring in that Whisper White cardstock and our Night of Navy ink pad. And the first thing I want to do is I want to start with the sentiment. I'm using a nice long sentiment for this one. Snowflake wishes for a Merry Christmas. And when you stamp this, I want you to come not all the way at the top, but maybe just about a third of the way down. So we'll stamp that right there. Now let's come in and we're going to add some snowflakes all around. And we're going to start with the Misty Moonlight. And we're actually going to do a little stamp off technique. That's why I wanted my grid paper underneath me. So I've got this nice collection of snowflakes, but you see it's a pretty dark blue. So I'm going to stamp off once and then stamp onto my cardstock. Do you see that nice lighter color? It's a great way to kind of get double duty from your ink pads too. So just stamp off and stamp onto your cardstock. So we'll get one more here. I'm going to be adding another color, so I don't need to fill all that in. Now I'm going to come in with Balmy Blue, and I'm going to take one of these small snowflakes from the collection. This one I thought was awfully pretty, and we're just going to kind of fill in. It's going to give me just enough of that Balmy Blue color. You see, we're not going crazy because we've still got to fill this with our snow. I wanted to die cut some of these little tiny snowflakes from that misty moonlight before I adhere this together. So I'm going to run this through my die cutting machine, and I'm going to get 5 or 6 snowflakes. In fact, I think 5 is probably a good number. So let me run these through my machine. All right, there are my 5 snowflakes. You notice I kind of kept them to the center because we're going to be using this piece of cardstock as a backing. So let me bring in my stamped image, and we're going to lay our stamp and seal all along all 4 sides. This is actually kind of important. You know, typically you don't really need that much adhesive to get it to stick, but I don't want any of my snow and my glitter and things like that, I don't want it to get underneath this stamped image. So you most definitely want to make sure you have totally sealed this up. Now, because we've got so much adhesive on there, make sure you're good and straight before you give that a press. I'm happy with that. So I know that that focal image is good, sticky, nothing's getting behind that. All right, it's time to bring in the clear envelope so we can put together our shaker. So here we go, clear envelope. We're gonna slide this into the envelope, and you're gonna put it down here in the corner. And you notice my sealed flap is here on the back, so we're gonna need that to seal. So push that down to the bottom. We're gonna take those 5 snowflakes that we die cut. Let's put those on top. Let's make sure they're right side up, Connie. Yep, we want those right side up. And don't worry, once they're in here, there's really not going to be any way for them to flip around. I'm going to bring in my kosher salt, and I've got 1/4 teaspoon. Guys, can I tell you, when it comes to this project, less is more. If you try to fill it too full, and honestly, my first one, I maybe did a heaping 1/4 teaspoon. It was too much. So don't think that, you know, adding a ton of this salt is going to make it even more fabulous, because it won't. All right, I'm going to, again, I'm pushing my focal image kind of down into the corner, and I'm going to add that salt right on top. Now, if you want to add some glitter, this is the time you're going to do that. Again, let me emphasize, less is more. Just a little tiny bit of glitter. We just don't want to overdo it. So I'm going to put that right there. And it is time to seal up our shaker. So I'm going to flip it over. You notice I've got it. I haven't started shaking or doing anything with it. I'm going to peel off the backing to my clear envelope, and I'm going to fold this over as tight as I can. That's going to seal that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this over, but I want to make sure I don't have any of this hanging off. So if you need to, you may just need to give this a little fold. Okay, just like that. This side, same thing. We're going to scotch tape it down. Good old scotch tape is going to do the trick. So again, over here, if you have a little bit that's maybe sticking off to the side, we don't want that to happen. So again, just a little fold and a little scotch tape. And then I'm going to go ahead, just to play it safe, I'm going to go ahead and seal that. Don't worry, no one's going to see it. Now you can kind of see, there's my shaker, and I hope now you can see why less is more. Because it all puddles up at the bottom. That's the reason why we wanted our sentiment up a little bit higher. But isn't that great? Now we can kind of, we can mix up that salt, we can mix up that glitter. It's just fun. All right, now we're going to take this, we're going to add it to that piece of Knight of Navy. Yep, that's just going to adhere right onto that, and it's going to give it that nice pop. Now for this, we're going to come back in with the stamp and seal. And it can be a little tricky to get the stamp and seal here on the clear envelope, but it does work. You can see I got my sticky on there. And I am going to go ahead, just like I did before, I'm going to go all the way around, because this is a little bit heavy, you know, with all that snow and cardstock going on in there. And we're going to add this two, that Knight of Navy, which gives it a really nice frame. And let me give this a little back rub on the back because I had a little bit of adhesive on my fingers and I don't want that to get on that clear envelope. Now let's add this to the front of our card base. And since we're just going cardstock on cardstock, we can just add some little dots of our adhesive and we are going to be good to go. We're just going to center that up on the card. Again, let me flip it over, back rub, and we're going to add that little ribbon knot. Remember that? And to do that, I'm going to press my ribbon knot onto a mini glue dot, and we add that right there in the corner. Oh, isn't it great? Don't you just, can't you just see yourself sending this to family and friends this Christmas and have them open that up and see that wonderful little shaker card? The best part about it, my friends, it was easy. We'll make the recipients think we worked really hard, but we'll just keep the easy part between us, okay? Thank you guys so much for joining me for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a thumbs up on YouTube. I always appreciate that. And remember, if you have not subscribed, it's a great day to become a subscriber. Just click that great big red subscribe button and get notified whenever I'm back with a new video. If you want more information about today's cards, head over to simplysimplestamping.com and you can see more photos, the measurements, and how to order any of the supplies you need. Guys, thank you again for being here. I look forward to stamping with you next time. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.